When we study the lives of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, we'll immediately realize that each Sahabi was given a special title. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu was known as Hibru hadhihi al-Ummah. He was known as the scholar of this Ummah. Abu Ubaidah ibn al-Jarrah was known as Aminu hadhihi al-Ummah, the custodian of this Ummah. So each Sahabi was given a particular title. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu al-Siddiq, Umar radiallahu anhu al-Faruq. From among these Sahaba, one particular Sahabi, that is Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman radiallahu anhu, he was known as Sahibu Siddi Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one who possessed the secrets of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He knew the names of the Munafiqun, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam confided in him a number of different secrets that he didn't tell anyone else. He told them to Hudhayfah radiallahu anhu very specifically. And to see the trustworthiness and the value that Hudhayfah gave the amana of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, even though he knew who the Munafiqun were, he didn't go out and broadcast their names. He didn't say, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam told me, X, Fulan, this person, they're all Munafiqun, be wary of them. No. He knew that it was an amana, it was a secret from the Prophet ﷺ, he would never tell anybody else. To the point that Umar radiallahu anhu, he had this concern that, look, we often go and pray Salatul Janazah, but I don't know if the person we're praying Salatul Janazah, is he from the Munafiqun or is he not from the Munafiqun? I don't want to pray Salatul Janazah and later on it turns out that this person was from the Munafiqun. How could I figure this out? Obviously, he can't go to Hudhayfah and say, can you tell me the secret of the Prophet ﷺ? Because no, it's the trust, it's an amana, he's not going to tell him. So what Hudhayfah would do is what Umar radiallahu anhu would do is he would comfort the janazah. Before he would go to the main congregation, he would look around. And he would say, okay, do I see Hudhayfah? If I see Hudhayfah in the congregation, that means Hudhayfah knows that that person is not a munafiq, so I'm going to pray the salah. If I don't see Hudhayfah, I'm not going to pray. That shows the extent to which they preserve the secrets and the amana of the Prophet ﷺ. This entire week, we've been occasionally talking about the importance of amana and the importance of trust. The one thing that the Sahaba radiallahu anhum held dear to them was to maintain the trust of someone, even if it means the own displeasure of people who are close and near to them. So maintaining the trust. There are just two things I want to mention before we conclude this conversation. The first is, sometimes we can have a conversation with somebody, and after we're done, the question is, how do I know whether it is private information or not? And I feel too shy to ask the person. So we learn in Islam, they say, when there's a conversation and the person says, can I speak to you privately? Or if the person is looking around, or if the person is speaking in a hushed tone, they do not need to say to you clearly that don't tell anybody. Just from their demeanor, I should be intelligent enough to realize that this is something private, I can't tell anybody else. And the second thing that is very important is, if somebody comes to me with a private matter and I want to help that person, I want to assist that person, how do I assist that person without divulging their secret? The way I assist that person, first and foremost, is I seek their permission and say, are you okay with me anonymously getting assistance for you? If they say yes, then I can share their information. If they say no, and they say that no, even anonymously do not share my information, then I have to maintain that trust. If I'm too shy to ask, in very general tone, somebody's coming to me and saying that they're having a very serious mental health issue, and I know that person's family. If I feel genuinely with ikhlas that this person needs help, I will go and very anonymously say that, listen, there are some issues that have been brought up. Please keep this very private. We need to work towards making a difference. Telling somebody else without a cause is unjustifiable. This is a very lengthy conversation. We can only scratch the surface. In summary, as a mu'min, as a believer, we have a responsibility to hold the trust of people that are verbal, like they're giving us money. Imagine somebody gives me a purse of gold coins, right? Will I go and spend it? No. Just like that, if they tell me something more valuable than the gold that they gave me was the private information that they shared, and I have to respect and honor that private information. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instill within us honesty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to maintain the trust of one another. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people who follow in the footsteps of the Sahaba, that they're able to maintain the amana no matter what. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Inshallah, after the remaining sunan, we're going to have our weekly hadith lesson. Everyone is requested to...